Just to know if your soul will fade at all. The one you sold to fool the world. You lost your self-esteem along the way.
Good God, you're coming up with reasons. Good God, you're dragging it out. Good God, it's the changing of the seasons.
Welcome to the show. My name is Allison Parker, and tonight to kick off the show, we hear from the boss. Slim GK just got stronger and stronger with the alliance of Gorilla Cruz now. Let's see what he has to say.
Alright, that's enough of that. Cut the music. I need to talk to all of you dweebs in the audience. And all you bums watching at home with your bucket of chicken, you disgust me. So, Sean and Chris, don't think I'm finished with you guys yet. You see, now that there's three of us, I wanna make a match for later on tonight. So, I was thinking, me, Victor Tolos, and Gorilla Cruz, we'll take on you two. That's right. I'm calling for it. A 3-on-2 handicap match later on tonight. So, you best get prepped, boys. Make sure you lace them boots up real tight. Because you're in a sticky predicament later on. I'll see you boys later.
Did I just hear that right? A handicap match for Sean and Chris? I don't know how they're going to manage. But coming up next, we have Chris Campbell speaking out live for all of you.
Hey, over here, put the camera on me. Yeah, JPG Management. I'm tired. I'm sick and tired of you feeding me all these bums week after week, okay? When I come to work, I want actual competition. Because lately, you've been feeding me these nobodies, these randoms. These nobodies that nobody's never heard of. So listen here, JPG Management. I want some real competition, oof. And real competition is what I better get.
Well, it looks like Chris Campbell didn't want any more local competition, like Slim said. Well, he's getting ready for something and... Oh, wait. Is that... It is. It's the world champion. The face of JPG. Karan Cook. I think he heard what Chris Campbell has been saying. And he's out here personally. The referee's out here in the ring and looks like we're gonna get a match. How exciting is this? What a way to kick off the show. Karan Cook takes on Chris Campbell. We haven't seen Karan Cook inside a ring since the last pay-per-view, so this one is definitely gonna be interesting. I wonder who's gonna win this. Make sure you drop some comments down below with who you think is gonna win this one to kick off the show. Well, he wanted competition. Now he's got it. Karan Cook taking on Chris Campbell. We haven't seen these two fight since Jester's War Games pay-per-view. And already Karan with the kick to the gut. And now suplexing Chris Campbell already. Chris Campbell gets back up to his feet as both men circle around the ring again. Sizing each other up and Chris Campbell picking up the champion and dropping his spine straight on the left knee. Taunting around now, but don't do that with the champ in your side. He suffers with a jumping clothesline from Karan. Karan Cook now. Throwing Campbell to the top right corner. Throws him to the bottom left. Campbell's in trouble. Going for that clothesline, throwing Campbell. Going for a rolling jump. Oh, and a super kick. Super kick out of nowhere and a cover from Campbell. One. That's definitely shot the champion, but only just kicking out at one. Blocking the jabs, and Caron is now striking. Campbell fights him off. Jab is reversed. And now back and forth between these two. These two remember what happened last time they faced off of each other and Caron got the victory. But it was a hell of a fight before he could get Campbell down for the free. Slapping Campbell. Campbell back with the forearm and a super kick again. Cover now from the X Factor. One, and the champion again kicks out at one. Caron Cook. Oh! Just getting slammed down by the X Factor as he goes up to that middle rope. And a drop kick to the champ. The X Factor on fire. And Caron's got to get out of there. Looking and just staring down the champion, already calling for a finish. Campbell showing confidence and strength already. Big running knee to the face of Campbell. And look at the X Factor. The strength of the X Factor. Just pushing off Caron as he throws him into that top left corner. Knife edge chop is reversed with a kick. And Caron throws the X Factor into the top left corner. Punches reverse. Back into the corner goes Caron. And Caron suffers with the strike to the face. And now just throwing him over the shoulders. X Factor picking him back up. Irish whip into the ropes. And just drops him down on the spine again. Elbow. The X Factor showing that he has what it takes to be the face of the place. Caron looking to be in trouble, but he ducks the punch. And now, again, Caron going for the net breaker this time, but Campbell reverses, outstrengthens the champ again as he targets the right arm and wrist. Picking up the champion now. And the X Factor gets kicked off, pushes him. Caron going for a suplex. And the X Factor for a third time getting out of harm's way with a chop block. So the back left leg. And now one more time slamming him down. The power of the X Factor. Chris Campbell calls him up for the finish. Center of the ring. Connects. Going for the pin. Caron in trouble. Two. No. The champion kicking out in two, and Campbell cannot believe it. He thought he had him right there and then. Champion gets put back up to his feet and he still kicks off Campbell trying to fight back. And look at that for a chop. Took him into thin air. He went flying. Drop kick as well. Caron trying to fight back. Picking up the X Factor with a slap, knife edge chop, a kick, and a rolling kick straight to the face. Chris gets back up. But Caron with the forearm turns him around and another rolling kick to the face of Campbell and the cover from him and only a one count. Both men back on their feet. Punch from the X Factor. Another punch. Going for the super kick again. Punch from Caron. There's the second, there's the third. Slap and a miss. Kick to the gut from Campbell. Campbell gets reversed from Caron. And Caron out of nowhere with a finish with that knee. Making Campbell go to sleep. Center of the ring too, and that might be it. No. Chris kicking out, and Caron can't believe it. As he pumps himself up with the crowd cheering him on. And the champion gonna throw Campbell into that top left corner again. And now, what's he thinking here? Power of Caron taking it to the bottom right corner and just slamming him down. What a match this is. And Caron gonna put more punishment to Campbell as he punches him. Uppercut, runs to the ropes, jumping clothesline. Caron on fire. Caron could win this. The champion not looking to lose. Two elbows now. There's a third. straight to the side of the face of the challenger, Chris Campbell. Campbell kicks him off. Big running boot. Picking up the champion. Axe handle. Reverse with the elbow. Karam. Karam with the running knee again. And Karam. Cook with the finish again with the left knee. Cover again to the X-Factor in a 1, 2. No! Two left knees to Chris Campbell and he kicks out of both of them. What does Karam have to do to put him away? Stomped to the wrist. And Chris has got to roll out of there. Chris Campbell gets back in the ring and looks to punish Karam Cook with a submission. And Karam is getting flipped over with nowhere to go. Could grab that bottom rope, but cannot reach. And the pressure is being applied to the knees and legs and lower part of the body of the champion. And the champion is struggling, trying to get out of this. Can he get out? The submission referee looking in closely, and he can. He's outpowering X-Factor and pushes him off with the legs. Punch of the miss, forearm from Campbell. Campbell, Irish whip. So the champion pops him up with a punch, knocking out the champion. Can he kick out at 3? 1, 2. Just kicking out at 2. The crowd is going insane for this match. Campbell throwing the champion into the bottom left, looking for a jumping splash. Reversed. Karam with the finish. Left knee again. Third time tonight. X-Factor is out. 1, 2, 3. And Karam Cook wins this one. What a way to kick off tonight's show. A 5-star match for definite. And Karam showing why he is the face of the place. Coming up for the second match tonight, Tenacious B will take on the former Four Arch champion, Isaac Luther. Another man we haven't seen in in-ring competition for a while, Tenacious B, the masked villain from New York, is looking to make a statement and to try and knock off the former Four Arch champion, Isaac Luther. These type of matches are pay-per-view worthy, and you can only get these sort of matches here on the most extreme place to play in, Jester's Playground. Let's help Slim out and like, share and comment. And also, if you haven't already, go check out our friends DWF, where you can get great action like this. Be sure to check out their latest pay-per-view Hell Games, as I'm certain you do not want to miss that. Isaac Luther, former friend of Tommy War, who is the manager here in the playground, who managed to throw Isaac Luther over the top rope and pin Sean Alexander to become our new JPG Four Arch champion. Isaac Luther is not happy about that, and which is confirmed, Tommy and Isaac will face off each other at the Jester's Rumble pay-per-view for his chance to claim back what was rightfully his in his words. But for tonight, he has to face a tenacious one. Crowd is ready, and so away we're going to kick off our second match tonight. And already Tenacious trying to run straight at the former Four Arch champion. Isaac Luther with the suplex going into the pin, only kick out at 1. Tenacious with the punches now, combination, and gets tossed over by Isaac. And Isaac targets the face with the left knee, Going for the cover, and a one. No. It's a kick out of one from Tenacious B. Tenacious with a spinning forearm, catching off Isaac, unexpectedly. Now picking up the former champion, throwing him into the top left corner, running straight at Isaac, and Isaac with the legs up, as a reverse on a running back elbow from Isaac. Tenacious B has had some tough competition here in the playground, faced off of one of the best in core, the Angry New Yorker, which he lost to at the Grand Pursuit pay-per-view in Paris, France. Now, Tenacious joining forces with the Gun Militia. As we all know, Keon Coto, the Motor Mouth Kid, and Angry New Yorker do not like one bit. Gun Militia feel like Eastside Ego Trip stole their moment to become tag champions here in JPG. When Keon and Angry New Yorker Chris James attacked Angelo and Travis Carter backstage to put themselves in the match against the Angels of Sin to become our tag team champions, still today holding the gold. Gun Militia feel strongly about taking those titles off of those two, and I cannot wait to see if this match will be confirmed for the Rumble pay-per-view. I'm sure it will be. JPG does have some issues with masked men running around. Gun Militia also feel like Eastside Ego Trip are behind those hooded figures, but they strongly disagree and say they have nothing to do with those guys. We'd only have to wait and see. We're only going to find out sooner or later. But back to the match. Isaac Luffer with the running uppercut to Tenacious, and now from behind, tilting and whirling and slamming down Tenacious in the middle of the mat. Now going for the submission, targets the face and the arms of Tenacious, just stretching him out there in the middle of the ring, and the referee's looking in closely to see if Tenacious is going to tap out. Seems to be struggling now, trying to kick his legs away, trying to outpower Isaac Luffer. Can he get out the hold? Doesn't look likely. Looks like Tenacious is going to tap now. Tenacious in trouble. Tenacious trying to outpower Luffer, and he does. Catches him with the elbows, breaks out of the hold, and now Tenacious grapples Luffer and clobbers Isaac at the back of the head. Isaac gets back up to his feet, but is met with series of punches from Tenacious, and now Tenacious is going to turn him inside out with this lariat. Bam! Isaac ate that one for breakfast, and going for the pin, two count, and Isaac kicks out at two. My God, you felt that one from here. Powerful clothesline from Tenacious as he goes to throw Isaac Luffer into the top right corner and just bashes his head on the turnbuckle. The full Nelson hold, and Isaac Luffer is busted wide open, but still manages to kick off Tenacious. And now Luffer with the code breaker. Now cover now to Tenacious. Kicks out at two. I believe Tenacious B is busted wide open after that code breaker as well. Both men are bleeding everywhere. Tenacious going underneath the bottom rope and using the ropes as leverage to get back up to his feet. But Isaac Luffer caught him off and DDTs him on the apron to the outside. Luffer picking up Tenacious now as he goes to throw him straight into the barricade and going to bring the big man back into the squared circle. The action continues on the inside as he goes up top, looking to fly. And Tenacious back up to his feet. Isaac going for that diving famouser, and Tenacious reverses it. And Tenacious with the gut punches, the knife-edge chop, and a spinning forearm again from Tenacious as he picks back up Luffer to his feet, throws him into the bottom right corner. Now Tenacious just biting the bloodied, messed face of Isaac Luffer. That can't be healthy. Oh my God! The athleticism from the big man himself, Tenacious, winding his opponent as he calls him up for the ball hammer. And now Luffer in trouble. Goes to cover from Tenacious, and Tenacious with the win. No! Not even a two count. How is Luffer staying in this? How is Isaac coping with this threat? Still manages to fire him off, going for the forearms and the elbows. Big clothesline from Isaac.
Hey, Isaac, up here.
Oh,
up here.
Wait.
Hello. Good to see you, my friend. I can see this little match that you guys are having down in the ring. Good job, by the way. You guys are doing amazing. I just wanted to be the person to officially let you know that our match at the Rumble has been made official, and I cannot wait to to knee your face off and retain my championship.
Tommy, what? Distracting Isaac Lufa and Tenacious trying to take advantage of that, but Isaac felt the sense and presence of Tenacious. He goes for the finish and now goes for the cover, going for the win. 2-3. Tommy Wall's plan did not work, and Isaac Lufa is the winner tonight, and Tenacious is not happy at all. Isaac Lufa with the win.
This Halloween, prepare your taste buds for Giants. Watsits and Monster Munch Giants. They're scarily giant.
Looks like he's trying to screw us again. Slim has totally lost the plot, man. I don't think there's any way to save him from himself.
The problem is, brother, it's you he has a problem with. This problem has spread to the whole clique because you wouldn't give him a rematch. But it doesn't matter. He's made the match for the rumble between you guys. Anyways, didn't matter what answer you had. He wanted this chaos to happen. And we're gonna put a stop to it tonight. All three of us.
Three of us? Bro, it's only us two against them. No one will want to tag with us.
Trust me. Let me make a goal. You're forgetting how many of our angels have sinned. We still have one brother left.
Bang.
It looks like Sean and Chris Angel have some backup plans for their handicap match tonight. The JPG Tag Team Champions are in the house, and they don't look happy at all. Let's see what they have to say.
You know, I thought I did a lot of talking. I thought I liked to let my motor mouth run. But as of late, Water Gun Militia, you take the cake. Especially one Eric Blackwell. So let's talk, Eric. You're making a lot of accusations. You think you're always 10 steps ahead. You think you know exactly who's under the masks. You think that me and Chris James are conspiring against you and your little water gun faction. Well, let me tell you something, Eric. If I have a problem with you, and I do, I will come knocking on your door like I am. And if you don't answer, I will kick that door down. You say you like to hurt people. Well, Keon Kodo is in a fighting mood tonight. Boss man, why don't you come down to the ring? Walk yourself down to this ring and make it official, because Keon Kodo wants Eric Blackwell in this ring, one-on-one, tonight. No mask, straight up.
Keon proposing a one-on-one between Blackwell, and here he comes with the leader, Damian Porter of the Gun Militia.
So you've been listening, you motor mouth bitch. You damn right I like hurt people. And for the first time ever, I agree with you. I'm in a fighting mood. So let's get the boss out here and make it official.
Now here comes Slim.
All right, fellas. I don't know if you heard, but I just booked myself into a match. So I'm going to make this quick. Tonight in the main event, Eric Blackwell, you will go one-on-one with the Motormouth Kid, Keon Kodo. As much as I like chaos, no interruptions between Chris James and Damian Porter.
Well, it looks like Slim's just made the match official for the main event, but coming up next, this match, Slim GK and his security team take on Chris Angel and Sean Alexander with a backup plan for them. I wonder who that's going to be. Slim GK likes to change his music to set the tone and mood for what he is in. And it looks like he wants to be cut up and fucked up in tonight's match. He's hoping for a war.
Yeah.
Are we all ready? I know I am. Let's see who they've got as their third man in tonight's match to make it a 3-on-3. Drop your comments and your guesses. This is going to be interesting. Who is the third member of this team? Oh, it's Wasp. Our United States champion, joining forces with the British heavyweight champion and the Intercontinental champion. Sean Alexander and Chris Angel just pulled one out of the bag and just stumped Slim GK. Wasp, a good friend of Slim's, has joined forces with Chris and Sean. We know whose side he's on, and it's not on Slim's. This is going to be interesting. The only man to ever defeat Victor Tolos is siding with Chris and Sean in tonight's match. And here we go, the boss is going to kick it off for his team and Sean for his. And already, Sean going for the move that busted open Slim some time ago to kick off this match, trying to make the boss bleed. Not successful, however, but did punish Slim. Slim back up to his feet and dodges the punch. Forearm of his own, jab is reversed with the punch from Sean. And now the back and forth between these two. Now Slim. Throw in Sean. Jumps over. Just slams him down. Look at Slim. He knows he can win this match. But Sean out of nowhere with the punch, turn him around. Forearm on the spine. Just places him down on the mat. Face first, and only a one count from Slim. Super kick out of nowhere to GK. And GK just pops back up and just pops him down. GK has not got no glass jaw, that is for sure. Kick to the gut and face first to the mat. Sean Alexander picking him up now. So he grapples him, togs the arm and twists it, puts him down, and a kick to the spine. And now, stomp. Handstand set on. A cover now to Sean Alexander, and Slim GK is going for the win, but only gets a kick out at one from Sean. Throws him, pulls him back for the hip toss. Now running double X handle to Sean. Sean goes underneath that bottom rope. Slim calling for it with a spear to the outside. Slim GK celebrating already. So the referee counts to one. But he's pushing Slim back to make sure Sean's got enough space to get into this ring. And as he does, Slim just not letting Sean get in this. And Sean with a super kick.
Come on, Sean, you can do better than that. Come on, hit me.
Well, you can hit a Slim, egging on the Intercontinental Champion to hit him again. So he goes straight back into the action, but Sean kicks him off. Now Sean throwing him into the ropes and a spear out of nowhere to the boss. As he goes for the cover, Alexander gonna win it for this team? No. Slim GK kicking out at one again. And now, Slim back up to his feet, gets thrown into the bottom left corner, and Sean running straight at him, but the legs are up from Slim, and Slim just pouncing on Sean and firing away with the strikes to the face. And Slim has lost it. And tag is made to Victor Tolos. Uh-oh. Sean ain't going to be happy with that one. And the demon just staring through the soul of Sean Alexander as he backs away to tag in Chris Angel. And now we're going to get Angel taking on Tolos. Angel is due a rematch clause for the Universal Championship that Victor Tolos holds. When he will set his eyes on that Universal Championship, I have no idea, but a dropkick from Tolos. As Chris Angel's strike did not bother him one bit. And now Tolos begging Chris to give him all he's got, and a clothesline from Chris out of nowhere. But look at the demon just popping straight back up as he stares down Angel. He gets outpowered now with the grapple and throws off Chris like he's nothing. And now Irish whip into the ropes, and Chris meets him back, and the demon slams him down onto the mat. Angel trying to get back up to his feet, but Victor Tolos is not letting him breathe at all. Angel kicks him off, spins him around with a big knee to the chin of Victor Tolos, and not even a one count. And look at him begging Chris to punish him And so he does with the enziguri kick. Victor Tolos has Slim and Gorilla Cruz wanting to get tagged in. But Tolos says he's got
it. Remember, 19th of November, bitch. You're gonna lose that title.
And the distraction from Slim, putting off Chris Angel as he suffers with the one-handed choke slam from Tolos. And he just laughs at Chris as he lays there, but watch out, Chris is kicked back up with a sling blade, rolls over, drop kick to the side of the demon. The devil is down as he gets picked back up with a knife edge chop, the punch, another punch, and a spitting forearm to put him down. Chris Angel now on the offense, picks up the demon again, throws him into the bottom left corner, and a knife edge chop to the demon. There's a second, and the third does not happen as he gets kicked off from Victor, but still fighting him off. Angel with the stunner. Angel on fire, and the crowd are loving him as he goes up top on that bottom left corner, looking to fly, and look at Chris Angel flying with his wings still on his back, and he goes for the cover, and only a one count again from Tolos. Tolos trying to crawl out of harm's way from Angel as he waits patiently for his prey. Angel teeping at the mouth as he throws Victor into the ropes and just bumps into him now. Victor's going to take advantage. A big knee to the face again. Victor calling up Angel. Angel getting back up to his feet. And watch out for Tolos as he's going to put him down with the pile driver. Jumping with the body of Chris. Look at Slim. Look at Slim now picking up Chris Angel, trying to get himself involved in this one, but Chris kicks him off. Kicks the boss off, goes straight back into the demon with the kicks. The knife is chopped, stomped to the foot, reversed, and demon Victor Tolos just pulls him down again. Now Victor gets kicked off by Chris Angel, and Chris Angel with a jumping elbow to the chest of Victor Tolos. Another jumping elbow, and Tolos is feeling this one as Chris sizes him up, going for the boot. Punch in the gut, Victor reverses. Victor Tolos just stares at Chris Angel as he puts him down again for the second time with a choke slam. Boyd pops back up out of nowhere and just puts down Victor Tolos. Chris Angel is running off fumes here, throwing Victor into the corner, tag made to Sean. Slim back in the match, made himself tagged in, ducks the punch to Sean. And now jabbing away, punching away at Sean Alexander, punched in the gut, and now he calls this one the Jester's Walker.
Alright.
Punch from Wasp. Wait, did you hear what Slim said? Slim said now. What does he mean by that? And Wasp picking up Sean, helping his friend up, and wait, no! Wasp! With a get fucked F5. What the hell is going on? And Wasp abandoning Sean and Chris as Slim gets back in the ring to take advantage. No, not like this. Not like this. And Slim and his security team with the win. Wasp just betrayed Chris and Sean out of nowhere. Maybe Slim was one step ahead and knew that they were going to pick Wasp this match. Nonetheless, we know whose side Wasp is on, and it's on the bosses. Coming up for our main event, we have Eric Blackwell taking on Keon Kodo in a one-on-one match. This guy has three words, and three words only, for anyone who gets in his way or the gun militias. He hurts people. I can guarantee the former hardcore champion Eric Blackwell is going to do everything in his power to hurt Keon tonight. Bitch, I just woke up, I check my clock, it's time to pimp. Bitch, I hustle hard, I hustle bras, I make my ends. You ain't my king. And here comes Eastside Eagle Trip, Keon Kodo accompanied by Chris James, the angry New Yorker. Last time we've seen the Motormouth Kid face off with Eric Blackwell, who is dressed up as a masked man to throw off Eric. Now, he's dressed as himself. Badass Keon Kodo, gonna take on Blackwell, but this time for real. Here we go, main event time. Keon Kodo and Blackwell requested this match and it was gifted from the manager, Slim GK. And Keon showing some love to Blackwell in his own way. Knife Edge Chop is reversed and Keon reverses with the punch. Knife Edge Chop reversed again. And look at these two back and forth. These guys absolutely hate each other. Bad blood for sure. Big elbow from Keon as he goes the Irish whip Blackwell into the ropes. Ducks under Blackwell, jumps over Blackwell now. And a big super kick to the gut and an uppercut to the former hardcore champion as he goes to the middle rope and a drop kick is reversed from Blackwell. Blackwell now holding the hands with a big knee to Keon as he goes for the cover now and only a one. Yes, only a one count. Keon back up to his feet, gets thrown into the bottom left corner. Going for the kick does Blackwell but gets ducked from Keon as he throws him into the bottom left corner now. And now striking away, Blackwell repeatedly as he gets stuck into that bottom left corner. First the drop kick, and Blackwell out of nowhere with the punch, knocking down Keon as he goes for the cover again, and Keon kicks out at one. Keon Kodo absolutely hates the Gun Militia, calls these guys the Water Gun Squad. Blackwell has mutual feelings though when it comes to Eastside Ego Trip, calling both of these guys bitches. Goes for the belly-to-belly suplex and Keon Kodo reverses. Now Keon, with the grapple, ducks the arm and a DDT to Blackwell. Picking him back up now as he goes for the knife edge chops. Kick to the gut and a DDT again for the second time. Going for the pin and the referee is there for the count one and only a one count. Blackwell kicking out at one. Keon going onto the outside on the apron. Looking to climb and looking to fly. With the elbow drop to the back of Eric Blackwell. Look at Damien getting involved, trying to talk some smack into Keon and getting distracted as Blackwell takes advantage. Aiding Blackwell was Damien. Now punching away with the combinations on the headbutt to Keon Kodo. Now picking him up, tosses him around and meets him there with the knee to the face. Keon feeling that one. As he now targets the left knee. Oh my god, just using his old knee as a weapon against his. But look at Keon with the roll-up. Keon for the win. Keon being sneaky. No. Two count, nearly got the win. And look at Damien again, distracting Keon. And Blackwell with the punch. Picking up Keon now. Keon fighting back. Keon striking with the knife edge chops. The punches. And Blackwell says, bring me some more. And Keon does with the finish. Cover now. Blackwell in trouble. No. Blackwell got way too cocky there, but kicks up either way. And another punch, third time tonight, knocking down the Motormouth Kid with that same suffering punch. As he drags into the top right corner, slams his face into that turnbuckle. Now throwing him into the ropes, meets him there with a big move to throw down Keon. Just spitting blood now. A bulldog from Keon. As Blackwell rolls onto the outside and Keon is going to give Blackwell some space to get back into this match. And telling him to suck it. The arrogance from Keon, but you got to admire it. He backs it up with what he can do in the ring. Blackwell obliges and he gets over that top rope to come back into the ring and these guys are about to have a strike off Blackwell with a third strike. Keon retaliates. Blackwell's turn. Now Keon. Then Blackwell out of nowhere with his signature move Taking up Keon, lands the face straight into the double knees. And a cover now to Keon. He's in trouble with the two. Kicks out at two. Blackwell frustrated now. Keon back to his feet. Knife is sharp is reversed with the punch. And Blackwell gets ducks from Keon. Punches him again. And misses with that finishing kick. And Keon punches him around. Goes for the finish again. This time with the knees of his own. To the face of Blackwell. Second finish tonight. Two. No. Blackwell kicking out at two, and Keon believed that should have been a free count. And now, throwing Blackwell to the top right corner, running boot to the face of Blackwell. Now picking up Eric as he strikes him off with the punch. Second one is reversed with the forearm. And now popping up Keon for the belly-to-belly suplex. Keon better get back up to his feet, and Blackwell sizing him up for that finishing kick. And oh no, the masked man just attacked Damian Porter, and Blackwell's distracted. Blackwell can't believe it as the masked man runs away. And Chris James is going to follow in pursuit, but look at Keon with the roll up out of nowhere. He's going to get the win. If he does, Keon gets the win. Keon gets the win and runs out of there, and Blackwell is pissed off. Blackwell is fuming. The smoke coming out of his nose as he just targets the referee. Foy had this one. Shouldn't have lost it, and the referee is going to get punished for it. Masked Man comes out of nowhere to attack the Gun Militia one more time, but Chris James followed in pursuit to go after the Masked Man. Referee getting put down. Well, thank you all for joining us on Saturday Night Inferno. We do apologize for the delays, as we did have technical issues. But please join us next time you see us. It will be 19th of November 2023 in Las Vegas, Nevada, where we have the Justice Rumble pay-per-view. Don't miss it. And also go check out DWF, as more action is over there.